Hey, many fish. It's the 6th of January, 2018. Shabbat shalom to you. And, I'm just hanging out here, so I thought I'd share some stuff with you. If you don't mind just hanging out for a little bit, because it piled up quickly. It started this morning. I was just doing some study, and I was in 1 Peter 1. And he's talking about being born not of corruptible seed, and we're back on the seed again here, right? So I'm doing this seed study, and I decide, maybe there's something else that, the Lord wants me to look at today. So I go to my random Bible verse, and it pulls up 1 Corinthians 13, 1 through 3. So I'm looking at a 13:13 for one, and it talks about charity, and this is a very good book to study today if you're so inclined, 1 Corinthians 13. But anyway, as soon as I saw the 13:13 and related to some articles I was looking at earlier today, there were several articles. I mean, we got all kinds of weird numbers here, 96 and just strange things. So I segregated all the ones I was looking at and wanted to kind of show with you. And there's some funny stuff and there's some pretty wild stuff. One thing was they had this balloon accident yesterday in Egypt, right? One dead and 12 injured. 13. Again, right away I'm seeing these 13s again. Because I know we're being shown that this is, in fact, on. This is one of those things that you cannot avoid, you cannot hide from. This world is about to experience things that is never experienced before. And 639, that to me is very significant in my world. I won't get into that, but the 13 there, oh, look over here, 13th person dies. I mean, and it's just loaded. This was in Egypt. 36-year-old woman, and it pops into my head, this is the 36th anniversary of Ron Wyatt's discovering the Ark. 36 years today. So I keep going through it, and this took place in Luxor, Egypt, okay? This is where the obelisk in Paris comes from, and obelisk, it's just steeped in Synagogue of Satan related information, if you know what I mean. Bunch of it here. Karnak Temple Complex, all of this stuff. Craziness. And I could go into this deeper, but I'm just seeing 13s and 11s all over the place. I just am. I that's all I can tell you. So I continue going and I come across this article. This Mexican psychic predicts no U.S. and North Korea war. Now, this guy, you can read this if you want, psychic in Mexico that apparently people just continue listening to. I don't know why, but he's been wrong about everything. He was wrong about Trump, wrong about Maduro, wrong about everything. But I don't even know why I'm showing you this, to be honest with you, but there it is. Another one was the New York has the fewest crime murders in decades, right? But if you go through this, it is, I'm telling you, man, all these people do is lie to make themselves look good. That's all they do. There's another 9/11 there, the 335, all these crazy numbers. Again, they're just everywhere. I mean, you can't avoid this stuff. 70 years. It just tells me that, yes, I'm definitely seeing something. I just, so often, I cannot figure out exactly what it is I'm being shown, except I'm seeing tons of 9/11s, that the numbers are just everywhere. And believe me when I tell you, I understand how these dark powers and principalities use numbers. I don't know exactly what they're saying, but you got to be careful when you get into this stuff, because it has a tendency to lead you down. I mean, the rabbit trails are endless that you can go down when you start falling upon these numbers. If you're not in prayer, if you're not using discernment and seeking the Lord when you do this, it can take you away. It's not going to condemn you, I don't think, but still, you want to be careful with it. This one here, Ancient Rome's Sinful City at the Bottom of the Sea. And again, you can read this, but it basically just talks about the sheer, oh, look at this, 46, just debauchery, the lasciviousness, the ugliness of how they used to act and still do today. Except they do all this stuff in secret. It's ridiculous, okay? So I see the reason this one really stuck with me is because of this one. And the way that Drudge put it up there really caught my eye. 200 dogs, 32 horses, 232. That's what caught me. So, and it's in Rome Township, you know? Rome. Very strange. And so I read it, of course. Posted at 9/11, just so you know. PM and oftentimes can be used for 9/11. It's a 7 and a 4. Just telling you. Rome Township. A tip in December led to the removal of more than 200 animals Wednesday from a property in Rome Township that authorities had inhumane conditions. The Lenawee County Sheriff's Office reported Thursday a warrant has been issued for Sharon K. Evans, 53, who owns the property in the 8800 block of Shepherd Road. Okay? You can't make this stuff up. Now, my spirit told me, take that, put it in the gematria. 15, 16, 11, 11, and 13. Okay? That's what it is. 11, 11, and 13. So I continue. 88 of Shepherd Road. That's crazy, man. Being sought, abandonment, cruelty to animals. She turned herself in. She was released on PR. Police received the tip December 19th. They received a tip December 19th. What happened on December 19th? That was all this craziness. The 2,000-year incense burning and the freaky synagogue. Both on the 19th. The 12 years building this little bitty synagogue. All on the 19th. The woman was selling dogs advertised as puppies, and it was false. The tipster believed the conditions at Shepherd Road were inhumane based on the poor condition of the dogs. More than 200 dogs, 32 horses, 5 cats, and 2 peacocks. And I added them up in my head, and it's 239. And that just resonated in my mind. I couldn't figure out what it was, so I started searching a little bit for 239. Where did I see 239? And where it was recently I was there was an article, I don't know where it is, but it was about this MH370. I mean, how can we forget that, right? And there was 239 people on that airplane, which is 11/11. Okay, it happened on March 8th, 2014. March 8th, 11. I'm just saying, you know, I don't know how I'm led to all this stuff, but I am. There it is. So, I keep going. Let's see, there was more in here. Extremely poor conditions. According to the sheriff's records, Evans was running a kennel. She was allowed to have the dogs. That might be all I saw in this one. But gee whiz, I mean, come on. 88 Shepherd. Okay? He's coming, folks. I'm telling you right now, Jesus is coming. And calamity, unlike anything this world has ever seen, is coming. I'm telling you right now. You better heed my words. Seek the Lord. And I wanted to show you this other one that was really kind of weird that I thought was kind of comical, actually. There it is. Noah's Ark breaks loose in a storm and slams into boats in Irk Harbor. You have to look at this. You got to. It is, to me, it's just God's sense of humor. He's ramming this giant ark. I mean, this thing is huge. It's huge. All up into these, like, nice yachts and everything. It's hilarious to me. But, I mean, still, even in here, the numbers, 119-kilometer winds. You know, you got your 911s everywhere. And the arc itself, if you look at these dimensions, 13 meters high, this is built in the golden ratio-like sequence, if you will. Basically, to pi. You know, 1.618. Crazy. Everything will be linked for sure. And there's more. There really is more. But I wanted to share that with you. The last thing I'll show you is 239 in the Strong's. And please take heed of this. It basically means to weigh, to test, to prove, consider. Very good things to remember. That's in the Hebrew. But in the Greek, hallelujah. Yes, indeedy do. Hallelujah. Praise Yahweh. How do you like that, huh? That's pretty cool. And you know that that word is only used 4 times in the entirety of the Bible? And each and every one of them are in Revelation 19. That would be a good study for you. So, yeah. It's on like Donkey Kong. And I thought I'd just share this stuff with you guys because it's really cool. And I love it, and I have to, because I have to, because I want to. That's how it works, you know? You want to do this stuff because you know what's coming. And if you want to understand what's going on in this world, you need Jesus. And you need to seek him, diligently and humbly. So please do that. Today is the best day. So, I hope this enlightens someone. Or something. Either way, keep looking up. Armor up. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,